in the update. The Ultimate Warrior challenging the Macho King Randy Savage, and both men laying their career on the line at WrestleMania. I don't understand why they would both do that, considering the fact that they're both obviously in prime condition. They're both at the very peak of their careers. Why such a measure?
Well, first of all, I think you have to appreciate the amount of guts that it takes to put your career on the line with the greatest event ever. But I believe what it boils down to is that it's just not big enough for both of them. Oh, look at that ham hock.
Yeah.
Whoa.
Remember one thing, this man's future is not our responsibility.
Oh, my goodness.
Right, let me translate.
Look at that,
that
up in the air. Shoulder block. Nice tackle there by the Warlord.
Nice man. This man, future, not part of our responsibility.
Yeah. Well, what is your responsibility, Slick? Counting the money.
Get that. Wow.
Strong.
And there is the Duck Magazine. It's available this Tuesday. And on the inside hot rod, there is an article on the Warlord comparing and contrasting his strengths with those of the British Bulldog.
Well, I know with the British Bulldog, he has got something that the Warlord doesn't, and that's just a little bit better in the leverage department, which makes for his power slam. If he can get the paws under the Warlord and power slam him, he's got it done. But the Warlord is so strong, if he gets that full Nelson on you, the only way to get out of it...